Hi, and welcome to the video on scoring rules. In this video, we will look at what scoring rules are and how you can set them up in Zoho CRM. All right, let's get started. Often in sales, not all leads require the same level of attention. Sometimes, you might end up spending too much time on a particular lead who does not convert. Or, you might have missed some leads who, with a little bit of extra attention, would have easily moved further in your sales pipeline. Scoring rules help you prioritize leads, contacts, accounts, and deals based on touch points such as calls, emails, survey, social, and campaigns, and even record properties. They help you work on records that matter to you most and use your time wisely. Records are automatically scored as positive and negative touch points based on their engagement with you. For example, you can assign positive touchpoint scores when a lead answers your phone or opens and replies to your email, or even submits a survey form. You can assign negative touchpoint scores when the email you send bounces or your call goes unanswered. Similarly, you can assign positive and negative score points to records based on certain fields. These points add up dynamically to project a total score, based on which you can follow up with them. Okay, let's look at how you can set up scoring rules in Zoho CRM. Once you've logged into your Zoho CRM account, go to Setup, Automation, Scoring Rules. In the Scoring Rules page, select the module for which you want to set scoring rules from the dropdown here. You can set scoring rules for leads, accounts, contacts, and deals. For the purpose of this video, let's go with leads. Let's now define rules for the leads fields. Go ahead and click this Add button here. Let's say leads from the education sector in the US are your prime prospects. You can prioritize these leads by scoring them higher based on the corresponding fields. In the Lead Score, Choose Criteria pop-up, select Industry is Education. You can add multiple conditions to a single criteria. Choose Add and specify the points that should be added when the record satisfies this criteria. Let's say 10 points. Similarly, select Country is USA and specify 5 points. Click Save. Over time, when you find that the conversion rate is higher from a particular lead source, you could attach a higher positive score for leads that come from that source. So go ahead and add another criteria to add 3 points when the lead source is chat. Moving on, we have the email insights, survey, campaigns, Facebook, and Twitter. Let's look at how you can define the rules based on all customer touchpoint platforms that you have enabled in Zoho CRM. For example, when a lead opens your email and clicks the links or likes your post on Facebook, it's evident that they are interested in what you are offering. You can make sure to keep them on top of all of your other contacts by scoring them based on such actions. Under Email Insights, click Add. As you can see, unlike the field properties, the Add and Subtract status is predefined for these rules. You can also choose to change it by clicking this dropdown here. Select the rules that you want to be applied and specify the points. Always go by logic. For example, you could give 3 points for an open, 5 for click, subtract 5 for bounce, and add 10 for an incoming email. Once you're done, click Save. Similarly, go ahead and select your preferred criteria and specify the points respectively for survey, campaigns, and Facebook. When you are done, these scoring rules will be applied automatically for all the records that will be created going forward. If you want to apply these rules for the records that are already existing, click the Run Scoring Rules for All Records button right on the top of this page here. Okay, before we look at how these scores reflect in the records, here's a best practice for you. Go to the Leads module and edit your list view to include the columns Score and Touchpoint Score. When you click these columns, the records are automatically sorted, and you can work your way down the list and give priority to the records with a higher score. Now, click on this lead at the top, Charles Henry. You can see the score right up front in the business card view of this lead. When you scroll down, there's a whole new section called Score Summary that's added, where you can see the score, the positive and negative scores, the touch point score, positive and negative touch point scores individually. Notice that these fields are locked and you cannot edit any of these scores. These scores are updated based on the scoring rules that you have defined. The score here is 15, 10 points for the industry being education and 5 for the country being USA. The total score that you see here is a combination of positive and negative scores and touch point scores. Viewing this total score can help you with some understanding of the record's priority. However, it is better to look at the score summary individually to get the whole picture. Here's another lead, Jack Preston, whose score is 3, with his lead source being chat. However, the industry is not education, and the country is not USA. So between Jack and Charles, scoring the rules helps you prioritize the right lead, Charles, who has a higher score, and you can follow up with him to win this deal. Thank you for watching.